I got this little cuckoo clock on eBay. It arrived just a day or so ago. We're going to go through and restore it. It's in not too bad a condition, but there's some parts of it loose and they need to be reassembled and put together. That's the top. It's in pretty good shape. Got the original screws in it to hold it onto the chalet roof. The painting's not too bad for a cheap little cuckoo clock. Put that aside. First thing you notice is that this piece of timber here is missing, part of the roof. That's the original clip that held the top piece on. I'll remake one of those and stick it on. The rest of it's a bit loose also, as you can see. I'll reattach that properly. Then once I've redone this piece of the roof, I'll put another catch on there so that we can put the top piece on. Continuing down the clock, it says here made in Germany. The little cuckoo is a permanent fixture. There's no door, it doesn't pop in or out. As I say, it's obviously a cheaper version. We'll go around the side, see what we've got. The change, they seem to be in relatively good nick. We'll give them a clean. There's a little bit of rust on them, so we'll clean them up before we put them back in again. Now the back of the clock comes out, just slides down. Take that out. First thing we notice is that the bellows appear to be in back to front. They open from the back, not the front, but I think that might be standard procedure for this model, I think. One of them's working, the other one isn't. As you can see, it's seriously come loose there. Once we take them out, we'll put new paper in them. I can see over there, there's some holes in the paper. So obviously it's not going to work. Plus the top's just flapping around in the breeze. Little movement in there. You'll notice there's no gong on the back door here. It's just a cuckoo. And the cuckoo will bob up and down and its mouth opens. It's got a piece of wire that will lie on that and do that. And you can see the cuckoo. I'll turn it round. You can see the little cuckoo's mouth is open, bobs up and down. Right, so it's not in too bad a condition for a cheap little clock. You'll notice there's no weights for the chain, so I've ordered some of those. They'll come in from cousins in the UK. They should be here in a couple of weeks' time. But in the meantime, we're going to take the movement apart, check it, clean it, oil it, and get it running again. There's no pendulum with this clock, so we will have to work out how long the pendulum is. That's a pendulum leader there that I'm playing with now, as you can see, rolling backwards and forwards. So we'll have to work out how long that is, and then I'll get another pendulum to put on it, because we'll get this thing working. Now I'm hoping that's pretty, there's a little bit of casework to do on that to hold it together all in one piece. I have a feeling, well, is there any, nope. I have a feeling that these bellows may actually be glued to the side of the case, I think. We'll take the hands off first and see what happens after that, to see whether the movement comes out the front and this whole piece comes off or not. Right, we'll take the hands off, being very careful, because they're plastic and we don't want to break them. Take that little nut off first. It's a nut that holds the hands on. Put that in the dish. Take the minute hand off. Take the spacer off, which is that piece there. Then, very carefully, we'll hold that there, the movement there, and we'll wiggle off the hour hand. That is very loose on there. I think I'll have a look down the side here. I think, in actual fact, the face is going to come off this clock, and that's how you get at the movement. A little bit down the bottom there to lift it. Yep, that's come off. All right. We'll look at that in a moment. There's our little cuckoo bird. Put that aside carefully so we don't hurt the little bird. And there's our movement. Very small movement, as you can see. The chain's come off the driving wheel. The chain should sit. Drop down again. Chain should sit on top of that wheel there, but it doesn't. Right, first thing we'll do is we'll take the chain off to do that. We have a look at the chain. That's the end of the chain. The hook here has a weight that hangs on it. That's on the right hand side of the movement facing it. And this circle here, because it's only a one day movement, is to stop the chain pulling all the way through the movement and dropping out on the floor. And if you don't know anything about clocks, you'll have to take your clock back to the shop you bought it from and ask them to put the chain back in again. So that's what that's on there for. It's a safety mechanism. Right, first thing we'll do is we'll undo the links that are holding those together. Now, that's going to require two pairs of pliers, smooth drill pliers. Put the first one there. Hold that half of the link. And then this one, I'll then bend it down. So that the hook can slide out. I'll tighten up that link so that doesn't happen. So that we don't drop the chain or shorten the length of the chain. Come on. That's got him tight. Now we'll do the same for the safety ring on the other side. Where's our joint? There we go. First one. Second one, turn it down. Take the circle off. That's been done a few times. That link broke. Doesn't matter. We'll put it back on the other link once we set it up again. Put the ring aside. And now we'll stand the movements on its head. We can drop the chain down a little bit. Catch it in a pair of tweezers. Pull it out the front. And then lift the chain and let it drop through. Pull it through carefully. And there it is. There's our chain. Brass plated steel, I think, judging by the rust on it. We'll clean that up before we put it back together again. Now, before we can take the movement out, we're going to have to undo that link, the actuating link that runs up to the bellows. So I'll undo that. You'll notice I used two pairs of pliers when I did that. It's not a good idea to just bend bits of wire with one pair of pliers or in your hands. Use two pairs of pliers. One of them holds the piece of wire steady while you're bending or moving or manipulating the other one. It seems to be securely in there, but I think, judging by those two pieces of metal there, that we just pull the movement out and it slides in and holds on those. So, let's see if it'll move. Here we go. That side's come loose. And back to the other one. What have we got? That one's pushed out. I'll dive way down inside here. That other piece of metal. They'll push on that. There we go. The movement has dropped out. Turn it over. And there's the movement. Not much of it, is there? Now, that wheel goes on there. Tiny little verge up there. Absolutely microscopic. See what we got here. Now, we've got plenty of wires there. I have a feeling the bellows, the posts are glued in, I have a feeling. So if that's the case, we're going to have to, that'll be glued on top. We got a half a cuckoo. and that's going to have to be reattached. As I said, it's got some little holes in there, so that is going to have to be taken off. We'll have to take both those bellows off so that we can get at them, clean them up, and get them working again. I'll cut some new paper to put on those. And yeah, I can see glue down there. Just depends on what quality glue they put on it as to how hard it's going to stick or how much damage we can expect to do when we try to take them out. Right, I'll have a look at that off camera, because it's not easy moving everything round here and backwards and forwards. All right, I'll look at that in a moment. Now back to our little movement. Take that wheel off. They're pretty tight. I have a feeling this movement wasn't designed to be worked on somehow. That's the way it'll run with the weights on it. The weights on this side, it'll pull down, and that's the actuating lever that runs up to this lever here that operates the bellows. If I can get my hand on it, that lever there, the one there, that actuates the bellows. Those four pieces there could be turned round slightly. I'll give them a try. It's on there, right? I'll spin them a little bit, see if we can straighten them up. But I still have a feeling, even if we can get this off, this wasn't designed to be worked on. That one around a little bit. And that one sort of about right. Let's have a look and see. There. Still pretty tight. These little pins here, 1, 2, 3, 4, I've straighten them up just a tiny little bit, and now we're going to be able to separate the plates that comes up. So it looks like we'll be able to get the movement apart now. A bit more, and that one. Is that? There that goes. That one. That one. They're off. Now that one. And that one. Must be slightly askew, because that one's still holding it, that one there. Bring it back a tiny bit more, because the rest have separated. Certainly looks like it's ready to come out, but now we're going to have to, some of those are coming out now, we're going to have to lift this up, straighten that out. That will slide through the plates. And then we'll, being careful to do it, lift that out. Then the plates will come out. Here we go. There we have it. The back plate. And the top plate. There you can see the teeth that the chain runs round on. Run round there. And that. Our lift wheel there, our striking wheel, I think, is pretty seriously on there. I don't think I'll bother to take that off. It won't advance our cause anyway at all if we do. And that seems to be all right down there. All right. Well, we'll check those out, the individual pieces, and see what we got. Put that back there. And the escape wheel goes in there. And then the tiny little crutch sits on top of it there. Once we get that in there, then that sits there. All right, we'll clean these parts up. We'll put them back together again.
If you want to learn how to service, repair and restore 19th and 20th century mechanical clocks, then subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell.